Welcome back, baseball fans. Summer 69-72 Carryover League. We are beginning the postseason tournament, a three-week tournament that runs through the middle of August. It's up to seven-game round, then an up to five-game round, then an up to three-game round. The purpose is to slowly reduce the number of teams in the field to the 12 playoff teams, 8 division winners and 4 wild cards in the two leagues. So what we have is, in the first round, in the round of 7, let's take a peek at the schedule here. And we will see that right here, Detroit and Ohio in the American League North are playing a best of 7. Again, this doesn't clinch the division. It just distinguishes first from second place, or sometimes first from lower than second place if the second place team really bombs and falls behind the third place team. And after this round, then the first place team will then try and play for a division title by getting wins against other first place teams. The competition gets kind of ramped up there. But what has happened here is that the Detroit Tigers, a team that really struggled early on, has won 3 out of the first 4 games, and they now have a game and a half game lead with 3 to play. They need one more win, and that would stop this up to 7 right there. You play the minimum number of games to distinguish first or second place. Sometimes it works out to be a perfect best of 7, and that's what this happens to be. It's a perfect best of 7. Whoever wins the first team that wins 4 games will have distinguished themselves between first and second. So the Tigers, a game and a half game lead with 3 to play. Even if they lose 2 out of 3, they would have the tiebreaker. They'd be a half game ahead of Ohio, and they would also be plus 2 in the tiebreaker column. So that's why the Tigers all they need is one win the rest of this series. And it's a good matchup in Game 5 from Detroit. We have Don Wilson going against... let's take a look at it. Don Wilson, an all-star for the Ohio players, going against Joe Coleman, an all-star for the Detroit Tigers. Let's get started from the Motor City. Leading off for the Ohio players, Dave Cash. 2-3, grounds are short. Ohio player strategy is to jumble their lineup every game. They just until they find a lineup that does well, and they've been shuffling it all year. Gene Kleins, 2-6, base hit. Johnny Jeter, 48, is a walk. 2 on for Ike Brown, 68, is a K. And Chuck Hinton, 2-9, is a K. Dick McAuliffe, 59, grounds the second. So, in the first series they played earlier in the year, the home team won all 7 games with the Ohio players. The Detroit Tigers being the home team in 4 of those 7. This time around, the series opened in Ohio. They won Game 1, but it was the Tigers winning on the road in Game 2 behind Mickey Lolish. Then they won 2 more at home. So the road team is 1-10. 1 win and 10 losses between these two teams. And the Tigers hope it turns into 1-11. Jim Northrup. 5-10, catcher's card. An elusive road win is hard to find in this division. J.C. Martin's a 46, a catcher, and no out. No pass ball or anything. Al Kaline, 1-6, grounds are short. All right, top of 2. Willie Smith, 1-6, is a K. J.C. Martin, 66. Single 1-19, base hit. Daryl Thomas, 69, left. And with 2 outs, Lou Klimchuk bounced to 3rd. Bottom of 2, Gates Brown, 45, lines are short. Norm Cash, 110, is hit by the pitch. Willie Horton, 39, is a walk. 2 on, 1 out. John Roseboro, 1-3. Let's take a look at the John Roseboro card. Interesting that he would wind up He's not a Dodger. He's not a Twin. He wound up here as the Twins and Dodgers didn't seem to want him for some reason. The Dodgers had Tom Haller as a lefty catcher. The Twins had George Mitterwald, and they traded for Hal King as their lefty catcher. So Roseboro ended up being a free agent, and Bill Freehan needed a guy to team up behind the plate. So you have Freehan against lefties and Roseboro against righties. 1-3 homer, 1-11 double. And that is a big three-run homer for John Roseboro. And suddenly the Tigers can start to see the light. My gosh, they want to win this game just to get to 500, let alone trying, you know. I mean, it'll be pretty easy to win this division at that point. Ground ball to second for Kevin Collins, and a ground ball to short for Elliott Maddox. I mean, if the Tigers win this series 4-1, they'd be 18-18. Which is still sad, but enough to be the number 4 seed if they can hold on to win the division and as the tournament progresses. Dave Cash, 2-5 single. Gene Klein, 3-6, single 1-6, lineup. Johnny Jeter, 2-7, K. Ike Brown, 49, is a K. All right, 3-zip, bottom of the third, McAuliffe, 66, base hit. Jim Northrup, 2-7, is a K. Al Kaline, 46, is a walk. Gates Brown, 1-9, huh? We got to take a look at it every time the Tigers play, and this guy's in it. Love to look at this card. Gates Brown's 338 hitting card of 1971. 1-9 is a base hit in a left field. McAuliffe is a 15 runner, and Kline's is a +3 arm. He will score. And Kaline runs to third on the throw. You have runners on the corners with one out, and it's getting dire for the Ohio players. They'll bring the infield up for Norm Cash. 2-6, let's take a look at Norm's card, his 69 card. And what's really interesting about Detroit is that their veteran players, Norm Cash, Willie Horton, Jim Northrup, and Al Kaline, they actually age rather well, and they play very well into their early mid-30s at ages 33, 34, and 35 in the early 70s. So no reason to break up the band. Norm Cash, 2-6, triple 1-3 is a base hit, dot, dot. And it's 5-0 with runners on the corners and one out for Willie Horton. 67 is a K. And with two outs, it's Roseboro again. Sky's the center. 5-0 Tigers. In the fourth, Joe Coleman, the All-Star, trying to put his team into first place at the end of this round. Chuck Hinton, 69, bounce to second. Willie Smith, 37's a K. J.C. Martin, 311, bounces to second base. Bottom of four, Kevin Collins, 57, second X. Cash is a 3-E-23, and that's an error. This is like the worst I've seen the Ohio players play all year. They've been a very surprisingly good team, but not currently. Elliott Maddox, 64, catcher's card. J.C. Martin's a 46. And that's another error. This is really some bad baseball we're seeing. First and second, nobody out for Dick McAuliffe. 1-3 is a fielder's choice. Runners on the corners, they got to bring it up for Northrup. 33 pops the first. And with two outs, this is kind of could be your ball game right here. Al Kaline, 55 is triple 1-5 fly ball off the Don Wilson card, and it stays in the park for Don Wilson and the Ohio players, and we still got a ball game, barely. 5-0, Don Wilson, this is one of his worst starts all year as well. Daryl Thomas leading off the fifth, they need something going, grounds the first. Lou Klimchuk, 69, flies left. Dave Cash, 4-4, short X. Elliott Maddox is terrible at short. He's a 4-E-48, and that's a base hit. Just terrible shortstop and third base play for the Tigers. Gene Klein's 2-8, grounds to third. Joe Coleman has answered the bell here in Game 5. The all-star and the pitcher in the Detroit rotation with the best record this year. Better than Lolich. Better than McClain. Bottom of the fifth, but before we go there, let's pause a moment for station identification.
This is the shrimp trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
Okay, bottom of the fifth, Tigers. 5-0 lead. Gates Brown, 49, walk. Norm Cash, 211, first B, fielder's choice. Willie Horton, 17K. John Roseboro pops a short. We go to the sixth. Coleman's a starter nine. John Hiller is available. He's hardly been used in this series. He's got to pitch two or three innings if needed. Johnny Jeter, 45. Sky's all right. Ike Brown, 58 Ks. Chuck Hinton, 67, is a K. Joe Coleman is dealing in the Motor City. Bottom of the sixth, Don Wilson. Kevin Collins, 48 is a K. Elliot Maddox, 110 is a base hit. At the end of the inning, well, right now, actually, Dick Trzewski is going to run for him because he's a better defensive shortstop. And that awful defensive player is out of the game. Dick McAuliffe, 65, center. And with two outs, Jim Northrup, 47's a walk. Two on, two outs again for Al Kaline, the pitch. 45, skies to right. Don Wilson is willing his team, trying to stick around. He's put men on in every inning after the first. It's just 5-0, though. But the problem is Joe Coleman. Coleman has a five-hit shutout in the seventh. And it'll be Willie Smith leading off for Ohio. 66. 1-19 is a base hit. J.C. Martin. 56 is another base hit in the center. And Ohio has their best rally yet. Two on. Nobody out for Daryl Thomas. 43 Coleman. Right X. But this is Kaline in right field. He's a 2. E4 in right field over here. And it's a single dot dot. He just cannot make a play on the ball. Poor Al Kaline. Runners on the corners. In a 5-1 game, they're still going to play back with a big lead. Coleman's a starter 9. He's not broken, even though he's given up 3 hits. One of those was a fluky hit. Playing back for Lou Klimchuk, 48, is a K. Dave Cash, 45, is center C. And with two outs, this could be your ball game right here. Gene Kleins. Two on, two outs in the seventh inning. Let's take a look at Gene Kline's card before he swings. He hit 334 in 330 plate appearances in 72 for the Pirates, a very good Pirate team that didn't go to the World Series. This is a big swing right here with two outs in the seventh inning for Ohio. The pitch to Gene Kline's. 1-9, he comes through with a base hit in the center. And that will score a run. And Daryl Thomas will not get thrown out at third base in a 5-2 game. So you have runners at first and second for John Jeter. Let's take a look at John Jeter now. You're seeing how Ohio acquired a bunch of these fringe extra players who didn't have play full seasons but hit over 300. John Jeter hit 320 in under 100 plate appearances. But here he is. Two on and two outs. The pitch to John Jeter. 39 is a K. Coleman gets out of that. We go to the bottom of the seventh. But before that, it's stretch time. We've been listening to Stevie Wonder's Music of My Mind, 1972. And after that, it gets a whole lot better for Stevie. The next four records he would put out are amazing. Okay, bottom of the seventh. Don Wilson. They're all-star. He's going to pitch another inning. Gates Brown, 1-5, is single, 1-19 single. And maybe they should think of hooking him, as he's not had a good start, and they're starting to come back, and the Tigers don't hit lefties as well, is the thinking. So only 6 innings for Don Wilson. He will come out. The back end of Ohio is still very good. Tom Hall and Mudcat Grant. Tom Hall comes on in the 7th inning. He will face Norm Cash. The pitch to Norm Cash, 6'11", first X. Willie Smith's a 4E10, that's a single. Two on, Willie Horton, 4'4", short X. He's a 3E38. This team does not have good defense. It's a ground ball C. second and third, Roseboro will leave. It'll be Bill Freehan. Oh boy, he really messes up lefties, doesn't he? This is the batter right here with runners at second and third. So Hall will leave, as this pretty much is your game. And they're going to go right to Mudcat Grant in the seventh inning with runners at second and third and one out with the infield up. So Mudcat Grant to Bill Freehan, righty-righty, hoping that's the ticket. And Kevin Collins is a lefty behind him, but he's awful. So Bill Freehan, second and third, infield up. The pitch to Bill Freehan. 59 off of Mudcat. It's a ground ball C, but the infield was up, so the runners hold. With two outs, it's Kevin Collins. The pitch to Kevin Collins, 2-6, rolls to first. So Ohio is now, after this horrible start, playing pretty sound baseball as we get near the end of the game. 5-2, trying to save their slim chances of winning this division. And they have Ike Brown, Chuck Hinton, and then we'll probably see John Hiller if the first two get on. Ike Brown, 110. Sky's a center. Chuck Hinton, 33, is a ground ball to short. And with 7 2/3 in the books, they're going to pull Joe Coleman with a 5-2 lead, figuring that John Hiller can get the last four outs. The guys on the bench, the right-handed hitters, are awful. Robinson, Watkins, and Zoilo per se. So here is John Hiller trying to get a four-out save and put the Tigers in first at the end of round one. So Hiller batting for Willie Smith. Probably a guy who walks. Yeah, they'll go Dave Watkins. Take a look at Dave Watkins. At least he has some walks. Need a guy to get on base. He hits 176, but Bill Robinson hits 171, and Zoilo hits 236. This is why they're our expansion team, and they're very fortunate to be where they are. Dave Watkins, the pitch to Dave, 5-7 is a K. And the inning's over. All right, and we will simply move Ike Brown to first base. All right, 5-2, Jim Grant's will continue. It's Dick Trzewski. 43, left X, and Gene Kleins is terrible in left field. He's a 4-13, base hit. Trzewski appreciates that single. He hit 139 in 1969. Dick McAuliffe, 63. Pitcher X, E0, Jim Grant. Need a miracle here. As a 2, E0, and that's double play. With two outs, it's Northrop. 56 is a sky to right field. Mudcat slams the door. One change that they'll make in the ninth inning is that they will put Mickey Stanley in the outfield. He's a 1 in center field. Horton will go to DH. And here we go to the ninth inning. It's John Hiller against a couple pinch hitters. Batting for J.C. Martin will be Bill Robinson. Let's take a look at Bill here. He's not quite ready yet. He would bloom in the early 70s with the Pirates and Phillies. But this is a 69 card. Hiller to Bill Robinson. 2-7. Single 1-2-3, and he lines out on a 15. Daryl Thomas. 57 is a K, and with two outs, batting for Klimchuk, the last dude on the bench. Zoilo, your 1965 American League Most Valuable Player. Let's take a look at him. Things didn't really go very well for him at the end of the 60s. Zoilo's 69 card, and he'll probably be retired at the end of this year. The pitch to Zoilo, 1-4, is a sky to center field, and that's it. Four straight wins for the Tigers, finally starting to look like a team that won the World Series 2 years ago. And the Detroit Tigers have won 4 out of 5, and that moves them into first place at the end of this round. We can also do a calculus of what the third and fourth place teams need to do to both survive and push Ohio completely out. That's an option. If you fall out in this round, you could fall completely into fourth place and be eliminated. So that is a danger with Ohio failing like this. So, but we'll have to put the calculus together and figure out if that is possible. Hiller, nice little save there. He got 2 strikeouts. Another win, big win for Joe Coleman, showing that it's him, that he's been better than Mickey Lolich, Denny McClain. Good year for him. A walk and 10 strikeouts. Magnificent. Mudcat Grant did a nice job coming in, giving up a hit. Tom Hall came in the face. Kevin Collins. There we go. So Don Wilson. Yep, hit. Don Wilson takes the loss, unfortunately for him. 6 hits and 5 runs. He did have an all-star year, though. Big 3-run homer by the unlikely Roseboro really sort of tilted this game. Walk 5, struck out 4. 1019, 0108, 5828. 112, 5-4, 5-4, 112. And game 5 is in the books. The other two teams in this division, the Expos and the Indians, are kind of rooting for Detroit to get trounced, because it would have been easier, as Detroit was an extra additional game under 500, it would have been easier to pass the Tigers than the Ohio players, but it's still feasible. So let's start with Detroit. Break it up for your Detroit Tigers. Finally starting to look like a baseball team, and they are at 500, 18 and 18. But every division winner goes to the playoffs, and the Tigers are now hitting 259 with a 369 ERA. Ohio players fall to 14 and 19. And when we look at the scenario here at 5 under 500, you kind of have to look at the combined records of the Expos and Indians and figure out, is there a scenario where these two teams play up to 7 games and both are better than 5 under 500? And the short answer is no. And I think the Ohio players are safe. Because if the Expos, let's start at the bottom. If the Indians get better than Ohio players, or let's say they get even by being 5 under, that means that the Expos would be 7 under. So the Expos would be gone. And let's say the Expos get even with the Ohio players at 5 under. That means the Indians would still be 7 under. So the Ohio players will be safe in this round, as the Expos and the Indians, they will play an elimination. However, the winner of the Expos-Indians can move into second place. As you see, the Expos are just a half game behind the Ohio players, and the Indians are just a game and a half behind. So it's very likely that the winner of the Expo-Indian series will be your new second place team, and the Ohio players will fall from first, currently in second, but eventually in the third. That's kind of how we look at the tournament. It'll be a fun second round in this division, as only one team will most likely make it. We have played now 458 games, I believe. Let's see what we're doing year to date. 462 games, my bad. We are hitting 260 as a team with a 388 ERA. Better pitching and fewer homers than last year, which has kept the ERA last year was around 430. So this has been a new year, new regime. A lot of the 80s players are gone. All the 80s players are gone from last year. So it's a smaller universe of players. A lot of talent to be divided up into 32 teams. And it's tough sometimes. You saw the Ohio players bench. It wasn't very pretty. And that's why the league's ERA is this low. That's it tonight from the American League North. Break it up for the Detroit Tigers. They haven't clinched the division, but they're in first place and will probably win the division, I would say. Thanks for checking out the video. We'll see you next time.